Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
NASCAR teams test at Las Vegas and get ready for Daytona. Carl Edwards looks to turn things around at Roush with his old crew chief back this year. Drivers respond to the changes in points and the chase format. Those stories, our weekly fans forum, Mary Scully's point of view, and this week in Team Ford Racing, all next on Raceline. Brought to you by Mechanics Wear, the number one glove in NASCAR, and by Ford Bold Moves. They happen every day.
We're down to a week before the start of Speed Weeks and 2 weeks before the 49th running of the Daytona 500. It's time to go racing. Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Moore. Welcome to this week's edition of Raceline. If you listen real hard, you can almost hear the engines revving, getting ready for the start of the 2007 racing season. It didn't seem like it would ever get here, but folks, it is here. The Rolex 24 ran last week at Daytona. Next week, the start of Speed Weeks. Of course, the Budweiser Shootout a week from Saturday night. And then qualifying for the Daytona 500 a week from Sunday as we get ready to start the 2007 season. Steve Post and our Charlotte Bureau has been covering all of what's been going on during the off-season, visiting a lot of the shops, going to some of the test sessions. Steve, what is your take from what you've seen so far, from testing results and the folks you've talked to at the shops? What's your take on who's really going to come out of the box smoking this year?
Well, Joe, I think coming out of the box, it really goes back to the teams that ended strong last year. Hendrick Motorsports is going to be strong out of the box. The restrictor plate program, Daytona, is always good. Their intermediate program is good, and I expect that team to be very, very good. Roush Racing, I think they have a little bit of a rebound. One of the teams I'm going to be interested in to watch is Joe Gibbs Racing, specifically the Home Depot team, Tony Stewart. They were not happy that they were outside of the chase last year. They came back in those 10 races, won three of them. Tony Stewart has been quiet this offseason. I think that 20 team is going to come out of the box very, very strong as well. But overall, I think it's the usual cast of characters. The teams that were good at the end of last year are going to be good going into this season.
The teams tested at Daytona. They tested last week at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. From what you're hearing, what's the biggest revelation to come out of testing so far?
Well, it's still much of the same. Daytona is very tough to gauge because so many teams are on so many different agendas. There's sandbagging that goes on. Nobody wants to show their true speed except for some of the teams that are towards the back of the pack. That's why we saw Johnny Sauter being one of the fastest cars. Do I think Johnny Sauter is going to go to Daytona and win the pole and win the Budweiser Shootout or win the Daytona 500? No, I don't expect that. I expect them to be good, and that bodes well for some of those teams to move up in the rankings a little bit. So Daytona is kind of a mystery. After we get through Daytona, right now Daytona is a little bit of a mystery with it being a restrictor plate track. Then we go California, Las Vegas. I think the Evernham team is going to be strong once we get to those intermediate tracks.
We'll talk more about that Las Vegas test, which was held this past week, a little later today on Raceline. Don't forget, with the start of the new season comes the start of a new radio season. You can listen to MRN Radio and keep up with all the action. I'll be in the booth with Barney Hall. Steve Post will be on pit road again. He'll be working all the Nextel Cup Series races, and you can tune us in on a station near you or nationwide on Sirius Radio, channel 128.
Still to go today on Raceline. Drivers react to changes in the points and the chase. First, here's a look at the 2007 Speed Week schedule at Daytona. Stay up to date on all the latest NASCAR news on the radio. Listen to Joe on NASCAR Today. Check your local listings for a station near you. More of today's show right after this.
Race day. And every day, wear the tool that fits like a glove. Available at auto parts stores, Lowe's stores, and online at mechanics.com.
There's more to NASCAR racing than cars going in circles. Raceline takes you behind the action. Every week we go to the shops, to test sessions, and face-to-face with the biggest names in NASCAR racing. People make those cars perform, and we bring those people to you every week on Raceline with Joe Moore.
Welcome to this week's edition of Raceline.
Welcome back to Raceline this week. I'm Tiffany Ricardo with a look at this week's news. Well, as you've probably heard by now, NASCAR has announced some major changes for 2007 for the chase for the Nextel Cup format. There will be 12 drivers in the chase this year. There's going to be 5 more points for winning a race this season, and also the number of wins will determine the lineup in the 12-driver chase. So there's a lot of stuff going on in that format. As usual, there are lots of differing opinions in the garage area about the new changes.
Well, I think I think that's been probably a complaint of the point system for years, is maybe the winner of the race wasn't awarded any kind of incentive point-wise for that. So I think it's a plus. All the changes they made is a plus. Like I was saying earlier, I like 12. I think 15 would be better. But, you know, right now 12, an additional 2 spots in the hunt will make it it's going to make it more interesting. I think it's going to keep fans involved. There's a lot of drivers that, like Tony Stewart, that was just missed the cut last year. And I guess I'm old school. I like to see it opened up to 15 at least. But, NASCAR, I think, made a step in the right direction.
We don't care about that. Race car drivers couldn't care less how they stack it up. Just tell us the rules and let us go race. Now, there are some race car drivers who, halfway through when they told you the rules and you went and raced, will say, well, that's dumb. And those people really get on my nerves. But as a race car driver, I like to know what the rules are, and I like to go race. And at the end of the day, I know why I didn't win or why I came up short and why I'm not a part of the chase.
You know, setting the points by who won the most, races, if they're trying to get us to race harder to win, no amount of points or money is going to make us race harder to win. We do that. That's our goal every week. But some weeks you have to, and it's not that we're points racing, but you have to accumulate the most points because you might not have gotten the setup exactly right, or you might have had a flat tire and you're just trying to get the most points that you can. So they can do all of that they want, and I hope it works the way that they want, but we're not going to race. If it ends up being that everybody thinks we raced harder to win because of that, then that's great. They look smart, and that's good, but that's not why it happened. It happened for other reasons, I'll assure you.
The groundbreaking for the NASCAR Hall of Fame in Charlotte took place last week. Construction will begin on the facility right away, and it's expected to be completed by 2010. MRN Radio's Winston Kelly is going to be president of the Hall of Fame.
The day that the doors open for the NASCAR Hall of Fame will mark a very special beginning for the NASCAR community. The competition, the competitors, and the fans. And I look forward to being a very small part of that, as we bring the Hall of Fame to life to reflect the personalities, the growth, and success that has been exhibited throughout the decades. A place where those who built the sport will be honored, where the fans, old and new, will be able to come and have a very special experience. Interactive, educational, and exciting.
You know what, when I was 6 years old, I knew I wanted to be standing right here someday. So this is a dream come true. And to have a Hall of Fame like this, I'm so excited about the Hall of Fame. I'm in a lot of Hall of Fames all over the country, but there is something about when a guy says he's a Hall of Famer, whether it's baseball, basketball, football, whatever it is, when they say that guy's a Hall of Famer, it puts him in a league all of his own, and that's what this is going to be, in a league all of his own.
Travis Kvapil may not be in the lineup for the Daytona 500 at Speed Weeks this year, but he is going to be there in a truck. You may remember that Travis drove for the Tide Chevy team last year, which closed down at the end of 2006. Travis has moved over to Roush Racing to take over the truck that Mark Martin vacated at the end of last season. Well, Travis says the truck series may be looked at as a step down from the Nextel Cup series, but he says this move is definitely up for him after the team he was with last year.
It might be a step backwards, I guess, or a step behind in the short term, but for the long term, I really feel like my career is going to be much more prosperous being with Roush Racing, and I might not be at the cup level in next year or two or whatever, but hopefully 4, 5, 6 years down the road, that's where I'm at. Hopefully it's with Roush Racing. Being with a single car team last year, it really showed me the importance of multi-car teams and having the manufacturer support. And we just weren't able to have that over with single-car teams that were underfunded. And I see what Jack Roush puts on the racetrack every week, equipment that can win at every level. So I know for me to get back into a cup car down the road, a successful cup car, it was going to have to be with a multi-car team and a great organization.
And young David Ragan is taking Mark Martin's place in the Nextel Cup Series next year. David is the son of Ken Ragan, who was a Nextel Winston Cup driver back in the 70s and 80s. David says he's thrilled to be taking the place of a legend like Mark Martin.
It's pretty special. You know, I'm looking at these pictures now and seeing Mark, well, what he's done for this place and what only, you know, he's done for me. He owned a legend car that I drove for a couple of years back, two or three years ago when I was 16 and 17. And so certainly he's been a you know, huge part of Roush Racing, a huge part of my career. And for us to kind of connect here over the last year or two has been pretty cool.
And Ricky Craven's annual snowmobile ride raised more than $110,000 last week up in Maine. Some 400 snowmobile riders showed up to play in the freezing weather with wind chills exceeding 25 degrees below zero. That's dedication. That's going to do it for this week's news. I'm Tiffany Ricardo. I'll see you next week.
More of today's show right after this.
This is Bob. Seems to be a lot of rumors going around about this chubby Santa. That's because Bob made a call to Enzyte about natural male enhancement. And what did he get? Why, a sleigh full of confidence, a sack full of pride, and the one thing that every lady likes? The joy of a gift that keeps on giving.
Call or go online now to find out how to get a 30-day sample.
Enzyte, the once-daily tablet for natural male enhancement.
If you've ever been curious about natural male enhancement, there's never been a better time to try a sample pack of Enzyte. Visit Enzyte.com or call toll-free for a sample pack. Call right now and you'll also get two free packs of Enzyte Topical Rush. With an offer this big, it's enough to throw a parade. Sample packs are in stock now and shipped to you within 48 hours. Offer only good while supplies last. Limit one per household. Enzyte, the once daily tablet for natural male enhancement.
Welcome back to this week's edition of Raceline. We talked about that test at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. It was held last Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Steve Post joins us again from our Charlotte Bureau. And Steve, I guess the main reason for that test being so important is that new configuration at Las Vegas Motor Speedway.
There's a lot of reasons the team went to Vegas. They went out there to gamble. That's a great destination city. The guys on the crew, the team owners, the crew chiefs, the drivers, they love going to Vegas. But more importantly to them is that racetrack. The banking on the racetrack has been changed from 12 to 20 degrees. A lot more banking. And when the drivers arrived there, it wasn't all that smooth new racetrack that we see so many times. There was some bumps, specifically in turn number one, that are causing the drivers fits. They're hoping, though, that bumps mean side-by-side racing, mean drivers having to move up a groove and making for great action. So a lot of optimism comes out of this Vegas test, and very, very important test, not only for Las Vegas, but as they go down the season, very important to get a good start to the season as well.
This week in Team Ford Racing is brought to you by Ford. Bold moves.
Carl Edwards is not starting 2007 as a new season, but as a continuation of 2006. After all, his team started coming on good near the end of last year.
I remember telling somebody, it's like, I'm not thinking of it as, you know, two separate seasons. I feel like we've already started the season. Daytona's the 11th race. We're just going in and cruising along, because we did finish the season really well. I mean, I think we had eight top 10 finishes or something in the last 10 races. So yeah, you got to kind of, there's no big shift since then. Everything's kind of stayed the same.
Carl points to the return of crew chief Bob Osborne as his biggest boost for this year.
It's cool to have Bob back. Bob and I have a great relationship, and it's pretty much like just an open door, man, open book, however you say it. Whatever, if he thinks I'm doing something wrong, man, he'll tell me. If I think he's doing something wrong, I'll tell him. And sometimes we argue and bicker and everything, but at the end of the day, I know Bob's an honest person who really wants to win badly, and to have him back and to know that, that at the end of the day, our cars will be as fast as they can be, and he's in it for the long haul, that's as good as it gets.
Find out more of what's going on in Ford Racing and join the fun at Team Ford Racing. Find out more at FordRacing.com. More of today's Raceline right after this.
People love their hover round power chairs.
You made me love you.
I didn't want to do it.
I didn't want to do it.
Hi, I'm Tom Cruise, inventor of the hover round. I can't sing, but I can guarantee you, you'll love what you can do in your hover round.
I love getting out of my house again, and boy, is it easy.
I love hover round.
because it did not cost me one penny.
I'm amazed at the people who say they love us just because we got them their hover round at little or no cost.
It's time you fell in love with a hover round and learned how to be independent again. Call today to get this free information kit, which includes a free video and a free test drive certificate. You'll also get this special comparison guide that tells you how to choose the power chair that's right for you.
Call 1-800-773-0287 today. That's 1-800-773-0287.
Back on Raceline as we close in on the start of the 2007 racing season. Again, the Speed Weeks activities actually kicked off last week with the Rolex 24. The stock car portion of Speed Weeks kicks off next Saturday night with the running of the Budweiser Shootout. Now, everybody going to Daytona to run the Budweiser Shootout, they know they're going to be in the field. They qualified for that by winning Bud Poles last year or being former winners of the Budweiser Shootout. The case is not the same for those going to run in the Daytona 500. A lot of folks will go to Daytona Beach and come back home not making the race. That's because there's so many teams trying to get in. Now, you know how it's set up. The top 35 teams, based on owner points from last year, are locked in. Two more spots can be locked in from Bud Pohl qualifying. That is, if two drivers who are not in the top 35 run the two fastest speeds in qualifying next Sunday. Then they're in. If all that works, there's only five spots available. Those spots will be filled in the Gatorade qualifying races on Thursday, February 15th, making it really tough to make it into the Daytona 500 this year.
The actual qualifying laps are easy. You know, once you get in the qualifying races, you know, you're trying to be smart, you're trying to be careful, you're trying to keep yourself out of that situation where if, you know, the guys are running four wide in front of you and they wreck, they take you out, all of a sudden you're not making the Daytona 500. So I think in a way, yeah, it's kind of it definitely put knots in your stomach. You know, it's a tough, there's so many new teams this year, so many good teams, well-funded teams. It's definitely going to be tough for the Daytona 500. But as in the past, we've qualified very, very well. All of our, in the past, MB2, now Ginn Racing cars have been good. We've been able to duplicate cars. So we're expecting some awesome qualifying runs in time trials. So hopefully that'll help.
Joe will be one of those trying to work his way into the Daytona 500 along with quite a few others. Sterling Marlin, Michael Waltrip, Brian Vickers, David Rudiman. There's a long list of drivers with no guarantee of making it into the Great American Race. And again, qualifying and those qualifying races will be very, very important for them. Now let's see what Mary Scully's thinking about this week on our Racing Milestones Point of View.
Did you hear that Talladega Super Speedway has introduced a no-alcohol campground for families? I know that's about as believable as Mardi Gras in New Orleans without liquor, but it's true. Talladega officials say they're responding to race fans who want a family atmosphere for overnight parking. As everybody knows, a family atmosphere is often hard to find at Talladega's campgrounds, known for bear breasts, booze, and beads. Champions Corner will be an enclosed, RVs-only overnight parking area outside the track's first turn. It will have a strictly enforced no-alcohol policy for all park residents and guests. That means friends in those alcohol flows freely campgrounds can't wander over for a visit with an open beer can. For those in the Champions Corner, there will be some special amenities. There will be a newspaper delivered to the doorstep of each RV every morning for these campers who won't be too hungover to read it. Children's activities and even a worship service on Sunday morning will be provided by Alabama Raceway Ministries. At a time when less than half the cup races are sellouts, there's a trend among tracks to appeal to every niche market. This is a wise move for Talladega. If the alcohol-free area sells out and the families who come enjoy the race, no doubt a few more campgrounds will be made alcohol-free. I'm totally in favor of giving fans an alcohol-free place to rest between the heart-pounding action on Talladega Speedway. I'm Mary Scully, editor of Racing Milestones magazine, and that's my point of view.
Mary Scully's point of view brought to you by Sports Gear Racing. This is a year to expect the unexpected. Don't miss the Racing Milestones season preview and track guide, now on sale at Auto Trader racks in gas marts and convenience stores nationwide.
On last week's Fans Forum, we ask you what the biggest story of 2007 will be. Here's the one we chose as this week's winner. Doug Fields of Winsboro, Texas says the biggest story of the year will be the car of tomorrow. Everyone starts, even with unknowns. So Doug, we're sending you our Mechanics Wear gift pack and a year subscription to Racing Milestones. Now this week's question, what do you think about NASCAR's new changes to the points and the chase format?
Answer this week's Fans Forum question and we'll send you a great Mechanics Wear gift pack and a year subscription to Racing Milestones. Just go to our website at racelineonline.com. More of today's show right after this.
This is Bob. Seems to be a lot of rumors going around about this chubby Santa. That's because Bob made a call to Enzyte about natural male enhancement. And what did he get? Why, a sleigh full of confidence, a sack full of pride, and the one thing that every lady likes? The joy of a gift that keeps on giving.
Call or go online now to find out how to get a 30-day sample.
Enzyte, the once-daily tablet for natural male enhancement.
If you've ever been curious about natural male enhancement, there's never been a better time to try a sample pack of Enzyte. Visit Enzyte.com or call toll-free for a sample pack. Call right now and you'll also get two free packs of Enzyte Topical Rush. With an offer this big, it's enough to throw a parade. Sample packs are in stock now and shipped to you within 48 hours. Offer only good while supplies last. Limit one per household. Enzyte, the once daily tablet for natural male enhancement.
Back on Raceline as we close in on the start of the 2007 season and Speed Weeks at Daytona International Speedway. Steve Post with us again from our Charlotte Bureau. Steve, you've been following the activities of testing, and you've been to some of the tracks talking to teams and crew chiefs and all over the last several weeks. What is your take on who might be the breakout team this year? You know, in 2005 we had Carl Edwards. Last year it was Denny Hamlin. Who might be that breakout team in 2007?
I'm not sure I do see a breakout team this year, and that's easy to say when look at it. These teams are so deep and so good. Who's going to be dislodged is the problem up inside the top 10. I think if there is a breakout team, it might be the Chip Ganassi team, and specifically Juan Pablo Montoya. If they can keep their driver out of trouble on the short tracks, can get him up to speed on the intermediates, and I think he can be up to speed on the intermediates, survive the restrictor plate tracks, maintain top 10 finishes, top 15 finishes, he can go to the road courses and win. Denny Hamlin won two races last year, both Poconos. There's two road courses. Juan Pablo Montoya, he won the Rolex 24 last week, very capable of winning on those road courses. So you spur those wins. If they can keep him calm, he could be the driver to step up. The Ganassi team, they need to perform better than they have done in the past with different drivers, so that team needs to step up. But that's one of them I see. Other long shots, maybe Clint Bowyer, Richard Childress Racing, they've been strong. I think that team really came on good at the end of the year. Martin Truex Jr. also at DEI, he came on strong at the end of the year. I think either one of those teams, but I think it's going to be tough to jump up inside the top 10 because that means you need to bump some out of the top 10.
What do you expect from the Toyota teams at Daytona?
Joe, the Toyota teams scare me going to Daytona because it's simply a matter of numbers. Numbers, slow speeds. Their speeds have not been what they need to do. Numbers, there are so many of them. Only two of those cars are locked into the Daytona 500. Dave Blaney, based on last year's points, and Dale Jarrett, based on a provisional as being the past champion. Other cars were very slow. Blaney, I think, was the fastest one of their cars, and only eight spots are available. If Dale Jarrett has to take the champion's provisional, only seven spots are available, and a lot of drivers going to go for it, going to be going for it in Daytona. So I think it's going to be tough sledding for the Toyota teams.
Well, Steve, it's going to be a lot of fun, and it'll give us a lot to talk about this year, not only the Toyota, but the car of tomorrow when it debuts at Bristol in a couple of months.
Joe, so many changes this year with Toyota coming into the sport, but the car of tomorrow, and, you know, the car of tomorrow, we spent all last year talking about it as some big project out there on the horizon. The horizon is here. The car of tomorrow is here. It's no more talking about it. February 28th, the car gets on the track for its first real test, and a lot of teams have to remain focused on that while worried about Daytona, while worried about the Vegas test that they just completed, while worried about the start of the season. So these teams all have a lot on their plate going into this year.
Thanks again, Steve. We'll see you at Daytona next week. Next week here on Raceline, we'll talk about the Budweiser shootout, who's in it, how they got in, and how it runs. And, of course, we'll preview Bud Pole qualifying for the Daytona 500 as we'll be right on the eve of the kickoff of 2007 in NASCAR racing. Thanks again for watching us. Check us out anytime on the World Wide Web. We're at racelineonline.com. See you next week.
Raceline is brought to you by Mechanics Wear, the number one glove in NASCAR. By Ford, bold moves. Also by MRN Radio, the voice of NASCAR. And by Fast Track, the weekly NASCAR news leader. Find out more about our sponsors and contact us at the Raceline website at racelineonline.com. Watch past editions of Raceline anytime on the World Wide Web. Just go to racelineonline.com and link to the auto channel. Closed captioning on Raceline provided by Racing Milestones.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more automotive fun and information, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.